Purva.
Good evening, sir.
So tell us very briefly about yourself and about your academic qualifications and your work experience, if any, after you did your graduation, and your main hobbies.
Yes, sir. Sir, my name is Apurva Tripathi. Sir, 1 minute. I'm unable to see.
Yes, you're audible.
Okay. Sir, my name is Apurva Tripathi. I have done my graduation in Electronics and Communication Engineering from CSJM University, Kanpur. I graduated in 2018. So thereafter, I have been preparing for civil services examination. And so this is my second attempt and first interview. I have also given state service examination in which I was selected. However, sir, training has not begun of that selection. And sir, my hobbies include reading books, watching contemporary movies and web series, and cooking, especially Northern Indian recipes.
Apurva, you said you have been selected where?
Sir, in state civil service examination, sir, Uttar Pradesh, PCS.
All right. So what is the service that you have got in the state civil service?
Sir, I've been selected at the post of Assistant Regional Transport Officer.
But you have not joined so far.
Yes, sir, I haven't joined.
Good. So, Apurva, you have been in Prayagraj and also in Kanpur.
Yes, sir.
Both are cities on the bank of River Ganga. Now, in terms of Swachhata Abhiyan, in terms of Swachhata of these two cities, there is a lot of difference between Prayagraj and Kanpur in terms of the cleanliness of the city. Kanpur is considered to be one of the, you know, very badly managed city from all point of view, from cleanliness point of view. Now, can you draw a distinction between the two cities in terms of the Swachhata of these two towns, and in what manner, and what are the reasons for one of them being better and the other one not so good?
So the distinction between two can be drawn on the basis of the type of industries located on the banks of River Ganga. So sir, in Kanpur, it is known for its tanneries and its textile industry. So that water, that industrial effluents that flow into the river, that has caused great degree of pollution. So that is a major constituent factor. Whereas in Prayagraj, sir, that is not so the case. And sir, in development of sewage treatment plant as well, there has been issues which were faced in Kanpur earlier. But sir, however, with the Namami Gange program, sewage treatment plants across both the cities have developed. So sir, although there is a certain degree of distinction between the two cities in terms of the quality of the river water, however, sir, now through the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan and through the development of the river along its banks, so we can say that the gap is now being bridged to a certain extent.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, Apurva, you are from Uttar Pradesh, and Uttar Pradesh is going to have the assembly elections early next year. Now, yes. Tell me, what are the reforms, electoral reforms that you are looking at, which you always thought that these reforms should have been made, and you would like those reforms to be actually in place during the UP elections next year?
So one major reform is related to the decriminalization of politics. Sir, in that front, we need to work in making NOTA more effective. So we can learn from recent judgments by State Election Commission in Haryana, where it has said that NOTA will give the right to reject, and those participants, those contestants would be rejected. So reforms on these lines, and sir, also related to whatever offenses, election-related offenses are being practiced, that need to be curbed. For that, the state election machinery also needs to work at that pace. And sir, thirdly, there is a huge amount of misinformation campaign that goes around during elections. So that needs to be curbed, especially, sir, in the social media. So for that, social media should also be brought under the Model Code of Conduct guidelines on what kind of news is being there. Sir, these reforms needs to be taken so that the true deepening of democracy we could see in the state.
Good.
Thank
so
you.
Tell me, we keep hearing about digital divide. So can you tell me, particularly from rural area point of view, what is the effect of digital divide, you know, the negative impact, particularly in two sectors, health and education? In what manner digital divide can be detrimental to the people who are, you know, digitally illiterate or do not have the infrastructure?
Sir, digital divide is a reality in the rural India, given that the literacy level is already low, and now with the entire our infrastructure being based on digital level, so they are facing challenges. Sir, as it is in the healthcare sector, we have seen that during when people had to register at the Govin platform, so with the inaccessibility, so they were not able to get vaccination at proper time. So that is one thing. So second could be related to the telemedicine infrastructure that needs to be built upon. So that is also the healthcare sector in rural area is facing due to the digital divide. And sir, education especially so, given that in the times of pandemic, we are seeing that more and more the drive is towards the online education. So when there is no possibility of this type of infrastructure in rural areas, so children lack and precious years are being lost in the rural areas.
So Purva, I pass on to Mr. Khanna for the next round of questions.
Good evening, Apurva.
Good evening, sir.
Your hobby is cooking.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
So let's start with this issue of obesity popular amongst youth and population of the world, especially the younger ones. They are suffering from obesity. What should be done to check this problem of obesity amongst children?
So the first reason of the prevalence of obesity is related to the high intake of calories, and that much amount of calories are not being utilized in the day-to-day work because of the sedentary lifestyle that we have now. So, sir, for that, the calorie intake should be lowered. And secondly, the physical activities among people need to be encouraged more. And, sir, thirdly, the quality of the diet is also important. Although there are cases of obesity, but, sir, we have also seen that these people also suffer from various other deficiencies of vitamins and minerals, and also anemia. So, sir, on these fronts also, we need to work to make sure that this obesity is reduced among people.
Okay, Western countries have recently introduced banning of ads for junk food. So that is a very interesting step in this direction.
Thank you, sir. Yes.
Talking about your specialization, let's talk on cyber security. What are the areas of cyber security that India should focus on? And what are the technologies that can be used to ensure cyber security for India?
So the areas related to cyber security that we need to focus on, firstly, sir, is that a critical infrastructure, it is banking, finances, hospitals, everything currently runs on in the cyber world. So that needs to be protected. for that, sir, the service which we are employing, that needs to be localized. That needs to be within the country itself. The equipments that we are using, that also needs to be manufactured in India or in the countries that we could trust on. We could not trust countries like China in these sectors. So thirdly, we need to have a critical infrastructure control, as certain is also there in our country, to make sure that whenever these cyber attacks could be flagged early on in the stage itself. And so fourthly, indigenous defense cyber security infrastructure needs to be built to prevent the prevent any kind of cyber warfare that could be committed. So these would be, sir, in my opinion, things that we would require in arresting the cybersecurity threats. And so working towards, and if we see in a more micro approach, we could see that we need also to work on the data privacy of the citizens. We need to ensure that the integrity of the data is maintained. And so we need to make sure that people have full rights over their data. So that perspective also needs to be taken by while securing our cybersecurity.
The second part of the question was, what technologies can be used to do this?
So technologies, as in first, we can utilize edge computing networks in the country, because edge computing has been said that it is more reliable than the cloud computing which currently we are using. So secondly, we have to have local servers. We have to have data storage in our country. So recently, the UP government also has invited tenders for the same. So second, that needs to be done. So third, a deployment of cybersecurity personnel has to be increased. So we see in the social media, there are always cases related to cyber crimes are always happening, and people keep on tagging the authorities, but the disposal of the cases is very low. So similarly, the case in the online banking also. So we need to have a dedicated cybersecurity personnel who are abreast with the knowledge that needs to be done.
Okay. So what you are saying is that IoT will be a very serious threat if it is introduced in India. So what do you think about introduction of IoT in India?
Sir, IoT will not be a threat per se. It will lead to a greater scale and the speed in which the operations could be done. We need to make the IoT secure. And for that, we need to depend on our telecom infrastructure, the infrastructure that we have built on from scratch, and the components of which are tested properly to remove any kind of bugs or any kind of security apprehensions that could be there. So, sir, IoT as a technological thing would be beneficial for India, but we need to invest in a critical infrastructure also to utilize its benefits.
All right. GST has recently completed 4 years of its introduction. So can you quickly draw a balance sheet of GST, the achievements of under GST during 4 years, and issues that still remain unresolved under GST?
So GST was once a step towards formalization of the economy and a drive towards one nation, one taxation system. So, sir, in that, GST has achieved what it was desired. It was related to increasing the formalization of economy and having more number of people under the tax ambit. So that has been done to a certain extent. And, sir, the issues of compliances has also been resolved. However, sir, there are certain pitfalls to the GST as we see it now. So one is related to the GST compensation cess. That is a major issue between the states. So secondly, there is also issue of the high number of slabs which are there in the GST. So that deters compliances to certain extent. And so thirdly, as we are moving towards a cooperative federalism model, the issues between the center and the state in how the prices have to be determined has to be more streamlined in nature related to, because there are issues. Recently, we saw that on related to removing the GST tax, GST on various medical appliances. So there were some kind of disharmony between the center and the state about these schemes. So, sir, that issues need to be streamlined, and GST Council as a body is working towards it. So we would definitely see GST bringing more formalization and efficiency into our economy.
Good. Electronic manufacturing sector, how this can be promoted to achieve the targets of Atmanirbhar Bharat under the electronic manufacturing sector. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So have you heard the question or should I repeat?
Yes, sir. I heard the first part of the question.
So question is, electronic manufacturing sector in India, how to promote electronic manufacturing to achieve Atmanirbhar Bharat targets under PLI scheme?
Sir, under the PLI scheme, sir, various parks are being established. For example, sir, in Noida and Uttar Pradesh, electronic manufacturing plants are being established. Companies like Samsung are putting up their plants in India. So, sir, we see that we are moving towards the assembling of the manufacturing products is taking up quickly. So we also need to work towards design also, which we are lacking in the country. That would be required to make sure that India's Atmanirbharta in the electronic sector is maintained. However, sir, the number of products that we are manufacturing currently is quite impressive, given that this shows that the PLI scheme have been beneficial to extent. And sir, learning by this scheme, we are also now using it in the manufacturing of telecom equipments as well, which could be included in the larger gamut of electronics manufacturing in India.
Good, thank you. Over to you, Mr. Sumesh.
Thank you, sir.
Over to you, Sumesh.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Okay, good evening, Apurva. Am I audible?
Good evening, sir. Yes, sir, you are audible.
So let's talk about your option subject geography. We have seen climate change causing shift in Earth axis. So what will be the implication of shift in Earth axis?
So may I take a moment to think about the question? Sure. So the shift in the Earth's axis would have implications in how the seasons are there, because the axis decides when there is a revolution around the sun. So changes in the shifting patterns of the seasons, extreme weather events, we could notice. So that is I could make of it right now.
Okay, no issues. Recently, there were locust attacks in many states in India. So how does it affect crops in India?
So last year, we saw that there was locust attack in the western parts of India, especially in Rajasthan and Gujarat. So these locusts come in the huge quantities. So what they do, that they eat the crops. So that is one thing that destroys it. And so they also, when they lay eggs in that area, that also makes a difficulty in the farmers growing crops over there. And they have also been seen that these locusts have had huge impact, as we saw in countries like Kenya and other East African countries, that it lead to famine and devastations in the food security of those areas. So in terms of food security, locust attack are a big challenge.
Okay, Apurva, let's talk about Indian economy. Can you briefly do SWOT analysis of Indian economy?
So the strength of our economy is currently that we have a stable micro we have a micro stability framework that we are doing well in the inflation band as well. Forex reserves are also at an all-time high. Growth is also increasing with the removing the onslaughts of the pandemic from the scene. And sir, we can also see the weaknesses are also there in our economy because in the larger context, there are certain structural issues in the banking sector with high amount of non-performing assets. We have also the issue of shadow banking in non-banking finance corporations. And sir, we have a large number of population that has not been able to enter into the corporate bond market. So that is also one issue. So the opportunities for the Indian economy are immense, given that sir, we are a very large market. We have a high demographic dividend and the various reforms that the government is taking. So as we see in, as we saw in the Atmanirbhar Bharat or in the Make in India to Assemble in India campaign. So to make our economy more export oriented, increase the farmers' income, make it more oriented towards consumer demands. So that needs to be done. And these are the opportunities that we have. So threats, as far as I can think of right now, are related to our high dependence towards China in certain critical components that we need to make sure are eliminated and we develop a level of self-sufficiency in that. So secondly, is related to the our bilateral investment, bilateral treaties, whichever we had, have not been able to yield any very good results for India. So that also needs to be reconfigured to make sure that they are helpful. So this is the SWOT analysis.
Very nice. So one more question on your hobbies of watching contemporary movies and web series. Okay, so what is your opinion on regulation on recent OTT platforms and should they be made more stringent?
So earlier the regulations were related to self-regulation system we had. But now, sir, as a number of cases being filed in the Supreme Court, so the Honorable Court has directed the center to come up with a set of regulations. So, sir, the artistic element of the cinema needs also be to be respected and the context and the content of that piece of work also has to be analyzed before censoring anything. So, sir, regulations need to be there because as it is also under the Constitution, under Article 19(2), that there are certain restrictions to the freedom of speech and expression. However, sir, we need to make sure that there is a greater degree of self-regulation and the stringent regulation are used in very few number of cases when there is an explicit content that is not advisable to be viewed. And sir, age restrictions and user restrictions are there, so which is I think is a good step overall.
Good. So I pass on to Chairman sir.
So Apurva, Olympics 2021 are around, another 20 days left, and I have seen your DAF. You are a green belt in Taekwondo. Yes. So tell me, what is your assessment about India's strong areas, you know, in terms of our participation in Tokyo Olympics, where India sees some hope of getting some medals? And number two, why do you think India has not been able to participate in a game like, or maybe martial art of Taekwondo for these Olympics?
So the areas on which I think that India would have would do well is, so firstly, it would be badminton. So secondly, it would be the wrestling. We are good at it. So thirdly, archery. And so fourthly, I could think of a shooting and boxing. We are also good at these sports also. So on coming by, India is not able to perform well in martial arts. So the Taekwondo team is not participating in the Olympics. It was not even able to reach the qualifiers in the Qatar, which were held in Qatar. So we were disqualified at that level as well. So sir, the reason for this, sir, there are multifold reason. So one, the prominent reason is that the structure of the sport itself, sport governance, especially sir in Taekwondo, is not appropriate. We have currently an ad hoc body and not a permanent body. So secondly, as the sport is a new sport, it was launched in India in 1970s. So we do not have that advantage of it. And sir, it is not very prevalent in the at the local village levels or such. It is mostly a city sport, as we can say. And sir, thirdly, the athletes that come into these sports, they need to be given proper guidance all along. So we see that they have been able to perform well in Asian Games and South Asian Games, but the exposure that they need at the world level is still missing. So that needs to be done to make sure that a martial arts sports do well in Olympics for India.
Good. So Purva, we have asked you quite a few questions over the last almost half an hour. Any area subject you would like me to ask a question from, or anything which we may have missed out, that would be the last question.
Sir, on reading books.
On reading books. Okay. So, tell me, which are the books, you know, are you interested in fiction, or what kind of books you are interested in?
Sir, I'm interested in both fiction and non-fiction, but currently I'm reading non-fiction. So I have read recently Atomic Habits by James Clear and Deep Work by Cal Newport.
Okay. So tell me, a youngster like you, how would you advise, what message you would give to your colleagues or your peers or even younger to you, that instead of sticking to the computers all the time or electronic gadgets, book reading is much more beneficial than gaining knowledge from, you know, electronic media. What are the advantages and disadvantages you would like to message to young people?
Sir, advantages of book reading are immense. So firstly, I would try to nudge them towards reading books, to telling them that they can use audiobooks, so that would be easier to listen to the books, or read it in the device itself when people are spending hours and hours on the screen. So it is advisable that they read books also on the screen. So thirdly, sometimes we feel that we have to complete the entire book, and from page to page, we can skim some portions, we can read what we like, and we can read up to a taste. It is not that we have to read the best. We should start reading. Then you will realize what we like. So in that way, I could nudge people towards it. And so disadvantages, I do not think there are any particular disadvantages of reading books.
Well, I agree, yes. So good, Apurva, we have had a good conversation. So now our formal interview is over.
Apurva, it was very interesting talking to you. I think very important is that at the end of our conversation, one feels happy, satisfied, and the fact that we were able to, you know, understand each other's viewpoint. So it was very good. Coming back to specific means your personality, let me assess it. You are very confident. You have a very positive body language. You were able, your knowledge base is also good. Means I tried it on over a vast span, from junk food to electronic manufacturing, and you were able to address all the issues. So no specific point that I would like to make, just keep it up. One or two just points so that taki sanad rahe kehte hai na. So it is like I asked you junk food and what should be done about it. So one example is that ad banning Second, you can invent, you know, what, how we can protect our new generation from junk food. Maybe a warning or something on the packaging itself. So that would complete, you know, the circle of the question.
Yes, sir.
Then cyber security, I ask you key technologies for adoption. And key technologies, you could have named the technology. You did not name the technology. Like artificial intelligence and machine learning. These could be used in different formats to achieve cyber security. Areas, you picked up almost all the areas that were there for... You were saying something?
Yes, sir. Sir, in that question,
you were saying something?
Yes, sir. Sir, in the cybersecurity question, sir, I thought that I had to answer on very specific cyber-related terms. So I could think of only edge computing at that time.
I know. You only mentioned about edge computing. You could have added AI and ML also.
Yes, sir. That could also have been added. Thank you, sir.
Okay. And 4-year balance sheet of GST was very good reply. IoT was excellent reply. So I am very happy with our conversation.
Thank you so much, sir.
Vinodji, over to you.
So, Apurva, I think your interview was one where you know, I'm still trying to find out how to improve you further. So compliments to you for having done very well and in all respects. But just to boost you further, you are in a very good conversation mode, which is the way it should be. A very good thing about you is that you are organized, very structured. And this happens when you are well-informed, knowledgeable. Your range of knowledge was good. Your depth of knowledge was good. Your analytical ability was also very good. And you could recall all the salient and good points, the solid points, you know, within the limited time or limited, you know, answer. It was, your answers were precise, not too long, not too short. You were comfortable, you were confident, you were fluent. You were able to answer all the questions very well, which I asked you. Three little points. One, when you started answered your first question, I think there is no need of your telling that this is my second attempt. Please avoid telling this.
Okay.
No, your DAF is with them. The introductory, you know, question that is asked is basically to put the candidate in comfort. Because answering about yourself is the most comfortable thing that can happen with you. So there's no point in bringing out your weakness or even strength, I would say. Somebody may say, why was this my second interview? Last time I got 190. I mean, I'm just imagining that somebody can make this mistake also. But don't mention this is my second attempt, my third attempt. So better not to say anything. Simply your name, your what you have done, especially the graduation part, and then your experience, if any. If you don't have experience, you don't have to mention also. And that is why I said, if any. So you need not mention, sir, I don't have any experience. It is not a disqualification. So come out with your strengths rather than any of your weakness. And therefore, there's no point in making a reference to that. That is my first suggestion to you. The other suggestion is that you were, you know, in one or two questions, in answers, you were picking up words. You were thinking of the words and then mentioning them. You know, your pace had become a bit slow. But the good thing is that while you decreased your pace of delivery, you picked up the rightmost words. So I would not say this as your disqualification or something which is not good. You would know better that instead of, you know, replying fast and maintaining that pace which you may have maintained in some other answer where you were very fluent, you may make mistakes. So it's better to pick up the right words and be a bit slow rather than telling something wrong and picking up a wrong word. I hope I've been able to explain.
Yes, sir.
And if I'm right, then you can always mention what exactly is the truth and try if it is true that you were searching some words, not the answer, mind you. You knew the answer. You were searching words. So do some practice so that you don't have to give that impression that you are searching for words.
Yes.
That is my second suggestion to you. And third, which I'm not very sure about, you would tell me and confirm. Beech mein, probably, whether you said so or you said to.
Yes, I said so, I believe.
You remember? Sure. Yes.
Sir, so, I'm not sure.
So just be sure, just be careful.
Yes,
that
sir,
you know, many people I have seen, you know, we have been in an interview with so many of you. So many of them have, you know, instead of so, they say to. It comes, you know, automatically. So aap apne video ko check kar lijiyega.
Yes, sir, I will check.
To bas isko avoid karega, to beech mein na aake, so aa jaye.
Yes.
That is all. And Apurva, we have considered you very high marks. I think the best today, around 68% on the basis of your performance today. So you have a very balanced, complete personality, very well informed, poised, very balanced, and totally in command. So keep it up. And there's nothing that substantial that we can add. And if you get 68%, even more than that, I mean, it is not difficult for you to get. So anything that we can answer, any question if you have.
Were my questions too long today or were they fine?
No, they were fine. Okay. Actually, you were to the point. You did not talk anything irrelevant. And the best thing is, you know, what Apurva, always remember, I mean, you have already done it. I'm just endorsing it. You know, when you answer like this, firstly, secondly, thirdly, fourthly, you know, it gives a very good impression to the board. You know, that your mind is so clear about everything. Otherwise, you know, you lap up things, superlapping, less important thing coming first. So your mind is structured, 1, 2, 3, 4. Keep that up.
Yes.
So, because you had divided them into 1, 2, 3, 4. Even if somebody says that answer was long, it doesn't look like a long question, long answer. No, because you have structured it. Easy to assimilate, easy to understand. All right, anything more?
No, sir.
So all the best, Apurva. How have you done your exams, Bains?
Yes, sir, I think I've done fine. I'm not very sure how you get.
So anyway, if you have scored well, I think interview will really give you a big push. All the best.
Thank you so much, sir.
All the best, Apurva.
Thank you, sir.
All the best.
Thank you, sir.